Hi, in this video we're going to talk about how to use our graphing calculator to find a confidence interval if we're using or trying to find a confidence interval of a mean, and here we know the standard deviation for the entire population. So this really goes with section 7.3 of our notes. So here's an example. It says, what is the average credit rating? Find a 90% confidence interval for the mean or the average FICO credit rating scores of adults applying for credit cards. Okay, so here's the information we're given. We've collected a simple random sample of 70 adults who are applying for a credit card. The mean credit rating of these 70 adults, the mean rating is 688, and we happen to know that the standard deviation for the entire population is 68. Okay, so to do this confidence interval on our calculator, we're going to hit stat, go over to tests, and we're going to go down to Z interval. So you can see that's number 7. Okay. Now we're going to input the stats, not the data. Okay. So you'll see the first thing it asks for is sigma, the standard deviation. So we'll put in 68. Then it asks for the mean, which was 688. And then it asks for the number of people we sampled, our N. So that was 70. And then it asks for our confidence level, and we want to find a 90%, so it's already at 0.9. So we'll hit calculate, and it gives us our interval. So we did it here by hand, and we see that it was 674.63 to 701.37, exactly what the calculator gave us. So again, just a reminder, if you're doing this where you know the standard deviation, you're going to hit stat, go over to tests, and choose Z interval, number 7. Okay, then when you know this information, you'll scroll to stats and put in the information.